Superior vena cava syndrome is a common oncological complication which mostly occurs because of a tumor compressing the SVC. This causes poor venous return, resulting in a collection of symptoms such as dyspnea, edema, and plethora. Although rarely life-threatening, it can present with severe respiratory distress. Let's talk about its etiology and pathophysiology. The majority of cases are due to malignancy. However, there are non-malignant causes too. Of the malignant causes in adults, 75% are due to lung cancer, while around 10% is from lymphoma. These tumors tend to grow centrally and compress the thin-walled SVC. Benign causes are less common and include luminal obstruction from pacemaker leads or catheter-related thrombosis. These causes will require different management, including catheter removal and thrombolysis or anticoagulation. Obstructing the SVC forces some of the blood to divert to four collateral venous pathways in order to return to the heart. The most important of these collaterals being the azygous venous system, located on either side of the vertebral column, which has many anastomoses with the inferior vena cava. The presentation of SVC syndrome can either be slow or abrupt, with a degree of obstruction correlating to the severity of symptoms. On history, patients often have dyspnea, cough, and chest pain. On physical exam, you might notice that they have facial plethora and engorged veins in the neck and upper chest. One particular examination to perform is Pemberton's maneuver. This can be done by lifting the patient's arms 180 degrees for 1 minute. This might result in more obvious facial edema and plethora. In terms of investigations, an initial chest x-ray might be needed, and it might show a wide mediastinum or a mass. However, the most important investigation is to perform a CT chest, which might help you visualize the obstructing mass or thrombosis, and highlight if collateral vessels have developed. Other investigations might focus on elucidating the underlying cause, for example, a tissue biopsy of the tumor. Initial management should focus on symptomatic relief. This might include elevating the patient's bed and prescribing an opioid for dyspnea and pain. A trial of dexamethasone should also be started to decrease the tumor mass by reducing associated inflammatory edema. Definitive management should be sought in the form of radiotherapy. Alternatively, endovascular stenting could be performed, in which a self-expanding or balloon-expandable stent is inserted into the SVC, usually via the femoral vein. I remember this by thinking you have to dress for success in SVC management. You give patients dexamethasone, radiotherapy, or endovascular stenting after you've tried symptomatic management. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and hit the little bell for notifications in the future.